All right, so of course my first choice is Sweet Tooth. I'm in what's called live training mode. It teaches you how to play it, basically. I'm gonna show you a few things here. You know, it's obviously way better than before. You know, especially with transformation stuff here. Still has some of the basic controls like it used to be in Twisted Metal Black and all the others, just with some new advanced things. A little bit of new controls. It takes a little bit to get used to, but it's not too much different from the old versions. Now, you have special, you can transform, jump up, and you can fly. Sweet Tooth being able to fly is so freaking awesome. You wouldn't believe it. You can still use a special weapon up there. Throw it like a boss. Then he's even got his own special for up here. It's called BAM! So, that's pretty cool too. You can also custom destruction as well. Like, for example, these things here. Usually you wouldn't be able to make them go explode, right? Well, that's all changed. BAM! See? You can absolutely disfigure this whole area. Massive explosion. And unlike in other Twisted Metal stuff, you can basically destroy anything, and Sweet Tooth Special goes through things. Unlike before, in previous stuff. See, it still destroys things, but it goes through it as well. Which I personally like a lot, because with its low accuracy in general, it should have a special ability to do something, such as this. Now you got your basic weapons like before, you got your missiles, your three different, with, you know, your fires, your purples, and your powers. They changed up how you freeze as well. All you gotta use is directional buttons. Up to freeze, shield for right, and reverse fire for just backwards button. And then of course if they added a new feature, if you want to land a mine, you press click left, and then you got your mine set. Then they got this cool thing where you got this little dude with you, if you go to the shotgun, and he gets out the window, as you can see, and he fires, just like in Grand Theft Auto. So that's cool. And then you got your little toy thing here. Pretty fucking hilarious, actually. You can blow him up if you ever so choose. So they got some pretty chill stuff. Very much so updated graphically, obviously, from what it used to be. No complaints there, obviously. This is just my first official day of playing it. Yesterday I was goofing around with it, and I've already got the controls down very well, so it's not complicated like most games anymore, but it's still the basic stuff, just with a few new things is all. So that's cool. So he basically got the feel of things, I suppose, because pretty legit. I am way more than happy, because I've been waiting for this game to come out for, god, half the year, ever since it got bumped up like 4 months, and I am very happy with the results of this game. So moving on to actual gameplay now. Alright, and just for... because I kind of got caught off by this, but like in the beginning, to be able to even play online, you gotta look at the back of the instruction manual that's inside the gaming case, and you gotta enter a code so you're able to play online. It's not like Grand Theft Auto or any other game where you can just instamatically play. I guess it's to keep spam or something, I don't know. But, so, you know, that's a good thing to know before you even get into it. But, I'm gonna play around with that online when I get better, per se. And, you know, I got, like usual, your one-player, multiplayer, just like the old school games, but... I'm gonna do one player challenge. And I'm gonna do kill all bots. I'm gonna start out with just three. Put on pedestrians, because that's the new thing. They got pedestrians and traffic, which is very cool. So I like to put that on just because I'm evil like that. Then you get to pick your characters. You got Sweet Tooth, you got good old Reaper, Crimson Fury, good old Darkseid. Then for once, and the very first, you got a helicopter, which I plan on messing around with later on, of course. You got Shadow, you got Vermin, you got the Meat Wagon, you got Kamikaze, Roadkill, good old school original player back in the day, been through all the series, Roadboat, then of course Outlaw, which has also been throughout the game, then Death Warrant, big ol' honkin' Juggernaut, Junkyard Dog. So since I'm kind of used to Sweet Tooth right now, I'll use him. And the new battle settings are very cool. Like the maps are huge from what they used to be, so that's really nice. But let's see how I do on my first time officially like playing it. Although I don't expect very good results, but why not? Oh shit, coming up from behind. Oh shit. Look at that. Yeah, this ain't no easy game like before. See, when they freeze you gotta do that too. Yeah, my health is low, isn't it? I'm gonna try to Hulk smash somebody. Running though. Death is imminent. You need help. Damn, that sucked. Your health goes down way more faster. Alright, so this one is one of my favorite maps just because it's so chaotic. Black Rock Stadium, one of their coolest maps of a battle. I like it the most. So, bam! crazy ones. Stuff all everywhere. And they don't give you a lot of weapons in the beginning like they used to. You actually gotta go around and get them yourself. There's lots of stuff going on in this, so you can get killed by pretty much anything, anytime. So you got to be careful where you go. So this is obviously going to be one of my favorites.
Woo!
Man, if you fall in that lava, it's like that Tokyo level on Twisted Metal, where you die slowly. It's like the most high-tech, complicated worlds they got here. Like I said, Twisted Metal could not have done any better, to be honest. So I'm very happy with the results. This level of itself is like its own little universe, really.
Whee!
Electricity over there to shock your ass dead and all that. That's just crazy. But yeah, very cool. Ah, crap. Vengeance. Ah! Yeah! I killed them both! I've just won. So, as you can see, it's a very, very advanced version of its own self. And overall, I got to admit, it's the very best of all the Twisted Metal series. Not disappointed at all. As you can see, the more you play it, the better you get. So overall, I got to say, once I start nonstop playing this and whatnot, I'm going to be like one of the very best, because this is my very second PlayStation 3 game. So between this and Grand Theft Auto, I'm gonna be like the boss of all of them. So I guess that will be all for now.